So the 4x100 meter relay is all about timing between the incoming runner and the outgoing runner. At a point, I would hit a mark. The outgoing runner would see me hit that mark, and at that point, he would take off. Now, he's got to give me a good target and listen. He can't look at me. His head is headed that way. He's turned that way, and he will hear me give a command, hey, and he will at that point give me a good high target to exchange the baton to him. But it is a blind handoff, so he never gets a chance to see me. So there has to be a tremendous amount of trust with the outgoing runner for me, the incoming runner. And this is after several practices and lots of working together to get the timing just right based on his speed and based on my speed so that we can then meet between the two yellow lines that signal the zone.
So I have to know you really well. So what happens, for example, if you're having a blinding run, yeah? You've risen to the occasion and I go off a bit too slow. That's my fault, isn't it? The outgoing runner has to go out flat out.
Absolutely. So then you have the U.S. team who always drops the baton because the timing is not right.
Join
you have
club.
To work this. You have to work on this so much because, yeah, you have to have the trust that I'm going to be able to catch you before you go to get to that zone. Now, most of the responsibility, though, is on the outgoing runner because you can see the end of the zone. If you don't hear me say, hey, and you see yourself getting to the end of that zone, you've got to slow down. And if you have to, you have to absolutely stop progress, then do a visual handoff and take the baton.
Do you ever feel under pressure? Say, for example, the lane inside, you can see they're clearly ahead of you. What you have to do, just block that out.
Absolutely, and that's what happens. So you've got to be so focused on the technique and the execution of the baton exchange here. You can't at that point be focused on the competition. If they're gone, that's okay. You've got to make sure you exchange the baton within the zone, and then you got to go try to catch them. But optimally, you're going to be able to extend in such a way where we're not close up on one another like this, but we're here. With your hair pointing that way.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So it's not the speed of the individuals, it's how fast I can get this little stick around.
Absolutely. You want this baton to continue its movement around the track and all of the exchanges seamlessly and smoothly. The 4x400 meter relay baton exchange is a lot easier. It's what's called a visual handoff. So the outgoing runner will actually keep his eye on the incoming runner at all time. Now, as the incoming runner, I'm getting fatigued. I've just finished the end of a 400 meters, so I've got to trust that my outgoing runner is not going to leave me hanging. He's not going to take off and leave me. He's going to judge my incoming speed and make sure that we get the baton exchange within the zone, but also to make sure that he doesn't drag me beyond 400 meters. So I'm coming in. My outgoing runner is now going to give me another good visual exchange with his eye on me, and then I let go, and now he's off.
The difference is the Japanese team in the heat didn't do that. As you said, you're coming in fatigued. I'm your wingman, you know, I'm looking out for you, but the Japanese athlete thought he had it, turned, and he stopped looking, and they messed it up. The key there, like you said, is a massive target.
The other key is making sure that you don't do the cardinal sin for 4x400 meter running is the outgoing runner. Never take your eye off of the incoming runner. He's got to keep eye contact with you, and you got to keep eye contact with him. If you take your eye off, he's decelerating so quickly, by the time you turn back around, just like what happened with the Japanese, he's 3-4 meters away from you.
And the difference here, apart from the first leg, which is in lanes, this is a real battle, isn't it? I mean, the officials will put you lined up here in whatever position your team in, but say I'm here, you could be there, and it is literally, isn't it? Like,
right.
You're literally doing this, you get out of my way, and you can be as
right.
physical as you want.
Exactly,
that's
because guys are getting up on you, you want to get as close to that inside lane. They position you based on where you were over there at 200. But if your guy and my guy is coming in at the same time, I want to get some room away from you because I don't want to collide into you. And what's going to happen is as soon as we both get the baton, we're angling for the inside lane and it's a battle for the inside.
And when it works well, it's a lovely feeling, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Because you're running for your mates. Pain or no pain.
And hopefully victory.